Ever want it to feel like you're actually inside your RC vehicle or aircraft? With the FPV head tracker camera, you can. It moves with your head, letting you look around and observe your surroundings as you fly or drive for a truly immersive experience. Using a few common motors, sensors, and Arduino boards, I'll walk you through how to assemble and set up the head tracking camera system, pair it with your RC vehicle, and get everything up and running smoothly. If you're ready to add a whole new perspective to your RC hobby, this project is for you.
To build this interesting head tracking camera unit, these are the parts and materials you'll need.
Laid out, we have every single part for both devices we're yet to build. Outlined above, we have parts for the head tracking unit, and below, everything for the servo gimbal unit which will hold the camera. You can find the full list of materials for this project with product links and the up-to-date project cost in the video description. Starting with the pan and tilt head, I designed it in Autodesk Fusion and made it so that each and every component attaches in the most accessible way, as this gimbal is intended to work on its own, like a demo, but ideally parts such as the base would be shaped according to your RC vehicle. So to 3D print these parts, you can purchase and download the 3D design STL files from my Cult 3D page, which includes more info like 3D printing settings to get them printed out correctly. Click the link in the video description. With my Ender 3v2 printer and some dark gray PLA filament, here's how my parts turned out.
Now that we're clear with what parts we need for the head tracker camera, let's focus on what connects each component to one another within the project. The PCB. And designing PCBs like this is easier than you'd think with the right tools. I designed it using Flux,
an online PCB design platform with an AI assistant that makes PCB design easy even if you're new to all this stuff. From placing components to making connections, the AI Copilot offers smart tips and corrections along the way.
Another huge plus is that Flux is an online ECAD software, which means you can design and review your PCBs from anywhere through your mobile device.
And one of Flux's latest features will save you loads of headache avoiding redesigning boards. Flux's AI Design Review tab, which analyzes your PCB for errors, suggests fixes, and ensures it's production ready, saving time and preventing costly mistakes for you makers and engineers. Whether it's your first board or your next project, Flux makes designing boards smarter and faster, just like I did for this head tracker's PCBs.
So if you're ready, click the link in the description below and start designing PCBs with AI for free using Flux.
But if you're more the type who prefers jumping right to the assembly, you can download the Gerber files for the head tracker's boards from the linked project folder in the description below.
And if you're looking to bring this design to life, I recommend you go with JLC PCB to manufacture your head tracker camera's PCBs. Whether you're a newbie or an experienced maker like me, they've got you covered with their user-friendly ordering process, which makes it easy to get your boards made exactly how you need them.
Simply upload your Gerber files, choose your board specs, and place your order. It's that easy. You can also track your shipment in real time while you wait.
And if you tackle more advanced projects, JLC PCB offers up to 6-layer PCBs with free via InPad, starting from just $2, and manufacturing done in as fast
as in 48 hours.
JLC PCB happens to be trusted by over 5.4 million customers worldwide, including myself, with the lowest prices yet top quality PCBs for your projects. Plus, JLC PCB now has a Black Friday sale, which offers up to $252 worth of different service coupons and prizes like a Samsung 55-inch gaming monitor or DJI Neo drone. Now click the link below for these exclusive deals and a chance to win one of those exciting prizes.
So once you've received both boards based on my design, we can begin soldering the surface mount components with soldering paste onto the camera unit's PCB. A blob of paste on each pad, and we can place the power LED, current limiting resistor, 10 microfarad and 0.1 microfarad capacitors for power filtering, and the 3.3 volt voltage regulator. Not that it's recommended, but I'm using a clothing iron to solder these components onto the heated board. However, if you're going to heat them with solder paste, either use an iron with adjustable heat up to 200 degrees Celsius or more, or simply use a proper SMD hot plate. Now let's repeat this for the head tracker transmitter's PCB and solder its surface mount components. Moving on to through-hole components, let's insert all the female pin headers and prevent them from falling out by bending a few of the pins. Shortly after, we can solder them in place. Now come the male headers, which are for peripheral, signal, power, and ground. If you don't have colorful pin headers, it's fine, simply don't confuse the rows. Then we'll also insert headers for 5V power input or output. Once the protruding pins are clipped after soldering, let's solder on some pin headers to the Arduino Pro Mini, the microcontroller. Using a perf board works perfectly to keep the headers straight while soldering. Now it's as simple as pushing in the Pro Mini and the NRF24L01 transceiver into the board. We've assembled them this way so they become easy to replace or reuse for other projects. To assemble the pan and tilt head, we'll melt in 5 of these M3 threaded inserts in parts that require bolts such as the camera to servo mount and the base. Once these are pushed in with a soldering iron all the way so they're flush with their surfaces, we can begin installing the 9-gram servo motors, starting with the pan servo. Then we can secure the pan and tilt bracket, or joint if you call it, followed by installing the tilt servo in the camera servo mount with the longest possible bolts from the M3 bolts kit. Afterward, let's mount the 5.8GHz 3-gram FPV camera. Originally, it has 4 wires, 2 of which are for the on-screen display data, which you need to twist together and solder if you're not using it. Otherwise, the camera will not work. The camera can either be mounted with super glue or some double-sided tape. Then we can push through the 2 little power wires coming through this hole to the rear. From here, we can solder extension wires to connect the camera to its source of power. And a bit of heat shrink wrap tubing helps prevent short circuits and the wires from breaking off. Now we can mount this piece to the rest of the unit while ensuring the servo's shaft is in its centered position. Using another dual female header, we can give the camera's power wires a connector which plugs into the 5-volt rail with polarity in mind. We've got to make sure that this pair of wires is long enough to allow the camera to reach its full range of motion. Same goes for the 2 servo wires. The pan servo connects to digital pin 3 and the tilt servo to pin 5 on the Arduino. After attaching the 2.4 GHz antenna, our head tracking camera unit is fully assembled, and it now needs a source of power, which will be an 18650 cell. So we'll take the 18650 battery's holder and use a bit of double-sided tape to mount one of these 5-volt boost converter USB modules, but with the USB Type-A header desoldered to make it more compact. This board simply sticks onto the positive terminal side of the battery holder with the boost converting circuit pointing inward. Now we can solder the positive terminals together directly and the negatives through a wire of the right length. For the 5-volt output side, let's solder a couple of wires to the tiny pads on the inside of the board leading out to a female pin header connector for an easy connection to the receiver board. From here, we can insert the 3.7-volt battery with the positive terminal facing the converter board and supply the stepped-up 5 volts to the receiver board through its 5-volt power input pins. To assemble the head tracker transmitter device, we basically need to place the same components as we connected up on the camera's receiver board, except for one key element at play here, which is the MPU6050 motion tracking sensor added to track your head's orientation. We can connect this gyro / accelerometer module through 2 male pin headers directly at the I2C through-hole pads closer to the middle of the Pro Mini. A convenient data and physical connection to prop it up. The only additional wiring needed here is for ground and power from the Arduino's 5-volt pin. This module can take from 3.3 to 5 volts for power input. Now we can work on creating pretty much the same source of power, only in the smaller package, using a 500 mAh LiPo cell to keep things compact for mounting to the FPV goggles. This stepped-up battery supply uses a JST-style connector for supplying power to the head tracker device. After taping it up a bit, we can superglue on a strip of Velcro and glue the fluffy strip onto the FPV goggles so the battery can be easily mounted and taken off for charging. The analog FPV headset I use is from iFlight and works at 5.8 GHz with an average receiving range of up to 400 meters. So now we can screw on the antenna and mount the head tracker unit to the goggles by inserting it into the conveniently sized cavity on top that this model has. So before we can use the head tracker with the pan and tilt camera unit, we need to program both of them. This can be done with what's called an FTDI USB to serial converter, which plugs in nicely with its 6 pins to either of the two boards. Starting with the transmitting head tracker unit, let's open its code. This is what it should look like in the Arduino IDE. Ensure you have these libraries installed from the IDE's library manager. Then check that these two transceiver pins are defined here and that no other peripheral uses them. Lastly, head over under Tools and select Arduino Pro or Pro Mini as your board. Check that its matching processor is selected and its corresponding COM port. Then you can hit Upload. Once the code is uploaded, we can plug the FTDI into the camera unit's receiver slash controller board and take a look at its code. Once opened, check that pins 3 and 5 are the pins you're using for the pan and tilt servo. These can be changed if you wish. Down here, you can set the servo's motion limits based on data and the range of movement if you'd like to adjust that. And lastly, you have the delay, which you can play around with to smoothen the movement of the servos. Heading up to Tools, the settings should remain the same as on the other board. From here, we can upload to the receiver. To download both of the code files, you can click the Project Files folder in the video description. Now, both the transmitting and receiving side for the FPV head tracking camera are all set up to work independently so far without integrating all of it within an RC vehicle. For a more firm attachment, we can add some double-sided tape for the receiver board to stick to the pan and tilt head. And bringing over the battery, we can now power the unit. Over at the FPV headset, we can insert the head tracker's transmitter and power it up. Once connected, we need a couple of seconds for it to calibrate and get its position. Then, once the Arduino's LED goes high, this indicates the sensor has calibrated, and we can begin moving the device around. For the camera's side, let's make sure its power wire is connected. Power on the FPV headset, and we've got video feed. But if not, we can press the search channel button on top, which automatically finds the active band and channel which the FPV camera is on. Manually, this can be done by pressing the band plus and or channel plus buttons until the frequencies are in tune with the cameras. If you find that the head tracking device is not calibrated with your desired motion limits for the camera, simply ensure the headset is pointing to the direction you want to observe from and that it's level and perfectly still. Then press the Arduino's reset button and watch the camera center to its new default position. And just like that, the FPV head tracker camera is up and running to track and follow your head movements. How cool! The FPV head tracking camera with its 9-gram servos has 180 degrees of freedom of movement for both panning and tilting. This is fun, but what about integrating this head tracking setup with an RC vehicle as the practical implementation of the project? Take my RC drift car as an example. Say I want both its pistol grip transmitter and the head tracker transmitter to transmit their signals at the same time to one receiver onboard the car for all operations including the pan and tilt camera. I confirm, yes, this can be done quite easily without the need of an extra receiver board. Let's connect up the drift car to the computer and open up these three code files. One is for the head tracker, another is for the RC car's transmitter, and the other is the merged code for the RC car's receiver. The way this is possible is because each of the transmitter's codes transmit through their independent radio pipe addresses, which are both processed by the RC car's code and are translated to the individual functions for operating the car and controlling the camera that follows your head movements. Once again, you can find all the code files used throughout this video alongside the three that work with the RC car in the video description below. Onto the installation of the camera unit to the RC drift car, let's connect it up. While the pan and tilt servos connect to digital pins 5 and 7 in that order, the other two channels on each side are taken up by the motors and other peripherals. After reinstalling the car's tail wing and crossbeam, we can secure the camera unit through a couple of zip ties on top. One thing to take note of is that the camera consumes more current than all the servos combined, which means that we need to power it from the battery directly from just one of the cells. With the pistol grip, transmitter, and head tracker powered up, we can now control the car and have our head movements mapped onto the head tracking camera at the same time to get a more immersive first-person view experience. If you want to copy this RC setup, feel free to watch and follow my tutorial videos with more info for both the Arduino pistol grip transmitter and RC drift car on my channel. But first, let's test out the head tracking camera with the RC car. Fun fact, I had the incredible experience of building this FPV head tracker live on stage in just an hour at the Electronica Fair in Munich, Germany. With Elector hosting me at their booth, I took on the challenge of creating this project under time pressure, a live audience, and lots of anticipation. And it even turned out to work in the end.
Yeah, it worked!
You can watch the live replay of the build with the kind host, Brian Tristan Williams, linked below.
Two-axis system pans the camera to the right, vice versa for the other side. And yeah, this system, the transmitting part uses the accelerometer, which gains your head movements data and then maps them onto the two servos.
I also got to meet some amazing creators like Great Scott and DIY guy Chris in person. The three of us makers had our own dedicated space at Elector's booth where we presented our projects, spoke to the public, and connected with our fans.
Good job, Max.
Thank you. Thank you very much for visiting me.
Sharing my FPV head tracker with visitors was also quite the highlight. Watching their excitement and even getting good impressions from Great Scott himself made the moment unforgettable.
It's a cool idea.
Thanks.
Like virtual reality, but just in 2D.
But in real life.
Yeah, in real life, yeah.
Many thanks to Elector for making this amazing opportunity possible.
If you found the project's tutorial video helpful and want to dive deeper, check out the tutorial blog I wrote on the Elector Labs project platform. It's packed with step-by-step written instructions, images, and extra tips to get your FPV head tracking camera up and running. So don't miss out on reading it, the link is in the description. So now that you've been given the instructions and all the resources to go out and build your own FPV head tracking device for your RC vehicle or aircraft FPV camera, will you go out and build one of your own? If you can imagine it, you can make it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.